Well, good evening to you all. It's good to join you again this evening. And I trust that you've had a good day today. Been a lovely, beautiful day outside once more. And it's good to be able to join together in worshiping the Lord. Many churches have recommenced as of today. Some are starting back in the next couple of weeks, albeit under great restrictions. So we pray that that will get better in the ensuing weeks. I'd just like to read something to you that Jesus said from the Gospel of John. And Jesus said these words, "I am the bread of life. He who comes to me shall never hunger, and he who believes in me shall never thirst. But I said to you that you have seen me and yet do not believe. All that the Father gives me will come to me, and the one who comes to me I will by no means cast out. For I have come down from heaven, not to do my own will, but the will of him who sent me. This is the will of my Father who sent me, that of all he has given me, I should lose nothing, but should raise it up at the last day. And this is the will of him who sent me, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have everlasting life, and I will raise him up at the last day." As I said a minute ago, churches are reconvening today, and albeit under COVID restrictions. Numbers are limited, as well as certain activities, and a lot of people have to book their place in most church services. The good news is, though, that fundamentally, the church is not a building. Neither is it confined to a building. Nothing can restrict an audience with the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Amongst other things that Jesus said in that passage that I just read, he made two simple statements, and they are these: I have come down from heaven, and secondly, the one who comes to me, I will by no means cast out. In other words, I have come to you, now you must come to me. I have reached out to you, now you must reach out to me. The awesome thing about our God is that he is what we call omnipresent. And that word omnipresent means that he is present in all places at all times. It's wonderful, isn't it? That doesn't matter where we are to be found on this earth, God is there with us. No matter what time of day or night it is, even if I wake in the middle of the night and I talk to the Lord, he is there and I have his attention immediately. God, by his Holy Spirit, therefore, can meet us and meet with us anywhere. David the psalmist said these words in Psalm 139, "Where can I go from your spirit? Or where can I flee from your presence? If I ascend into heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in Hades, behold, you are there. If I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even there your hand shall lead me, and your right hand shall hold me. If I say, surely the darkness shall fall on me, even the night shall be light about me." A number of years ago, in 1982, I was working in a car component factory here in my state. And over a period of 7 years, I had talked to people about the Lord. I had witnessed to the gospel of Jesus Christ. A lot of the time it seemed to be going on deaf ears, and it was quite easy to become discouraged when presenting the gospel. You think, doesn't anybody really listen? How much power is in this gospel? Because nobody seems to take any notice. And then one day early in 1982, I went into work, and my immediate work colleague was alongside me one morning, and as what it is, we would stop now and again, have a cup of tea together. And as we were talking about recent months, I just asked a question about how he had been managing in recent months. What happened in that moment of time was just absolutely amazing, because God seemed to walk into that place of work. And in the early part, now I'm sure that God had been with me in all the times that I had been working there and talking to people about the Lord. But on this particular morning, it was as if the Holy Spirit walked into that place and never left. He did something at that moment of time and in the ensuing years that was absolutely amazing. In people who I worked with come to the Lord and acknowledge him as their Lord and Savior. And on this particular morning, I sat with my friend, and as we talked, and as after I asked him that question, he just broke down in front of me and wept. And it was something I did not expect. It was something I was not quite ready for. Right in that place, lots of people about. And yet here, God, the Holy Spirit, had walked into that room. Why? Because God is omnipresent. He is not confined to a church building. He is not confined even to a company of people when we gather together. He has promised that when we come together that he will be amongst us as God's people. But he's also promised that wherever we go, he'll be with us if we obey his commands, if we obey him in presenting the gospel. His promise is, and lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the age. And on that morning, God proved to be who he said he was. He came into that place and began a work in my friend's life and in other people's lives that was truly amazing. God was glorified. And then as time progressed, I remember doing some night shift work, and I went into work one night, start at 10 o'clock in the evening, and then come about 1 o'clock in the morning, we would, it was a very skeleton staff on that night shift. And so there was just maintenance and fitters, electricians, myself as a tool setter. We were just doing maintenance on the night shift. And at 1 o'clock in the morning, just a few of us would get together in the fitter shop and have a cup of tea, sandwiches, etc. And invariably, whenever I would sit and talk to these guys, the subject of the gospel would come up. And I wouldn't have to bring up the subject, because I was there. They would start talking about it. And this one night, I remember it plainly. We sat there, and there was about three or four other guys there sat with me. And suddenly, again, the Holy Spirit came into that place in a powerful way. And after talking to them for several minutes, I actually said in kind of a bold way, I said, "Hey guys, we don't need to go to a church building for you to meet with God. You can meet with him right here in this company at this time of night at 1 o'clock in the morning. God is here. And you can meet with him right now." Well, in the days that followed, or in the nights that followed, I should say, because I was doing the night shift, I remember one of those fitters coming to me. And this is what he said. You know, he said the other night when we were talking, and he said, "And you said about being able to meet with God there and then." He said, I don't know what happened, he said, "but I wanted to get on my knees." That was the power of God at work in the life of these men. It didn't matter that we were not in a church building. It didn't matter that we were not gathered together as God's people. I was there as God's representative. I was there as God's ambassador. And because I was there doing his will and telling the gospel of Jesus Christ, God was there too by his Holy Spirit. You see, not only has Jesus come to us, But he tells us that we must come to him, as I said a moment ago. And the wonderful thing is that when we do come to him, he has promised that he will not turn us away. I love to go fishing. I have fished in rivers, I fished in lakes, I have fished in the sea. Each place where I have fished has its own laws regarding what fish you can keep and what fish you must return to the water. Some fish are regarded as too small, whereas in other places they're regarded as too big and you have to put them back. Some you'll want to keep because they're nice to eat, others you want to put back because they're not very nice to eat. Jesus made a wonderful promise to his disciples. He said, "Follow me, and I will make you fishers of men." The glorious truth is this, that God never, ever throws any fish back into the water. In fact, heaven rejoices no matter what sort of fish you are. No one is too small. No one is too unlovely. No one is unwanted. All are wanted by the Lord. He has died so that no one will perish, but that all will come to repentance. God desires all to come to him because he loves us and desires us to spend eternity with him. Listen to what Jesus said again in that passage that I read at the start. "This is the will of him who sent me, that everyone who believes in him may have everlasting life, and I will raise him up at the last day." God wants you. God desires to have you as part of his family. In this day in which we live, it is the day of God's grace. Today is the day of salvation. Come to him now. Again, back in the early 1980s, there was a conference in Mid Wales. And during this conference, during one of the services, there was a young man who, during the time of worship, began to sing this song that came to him spontaneously by the Holy Spirit. And I want you to hear the words of what came from his lips at this point in time, because what I've been saying to you this evening is confirmed by what the Holy Spirit said through the song of this young man. Come to him today. The Lord has come to us. Let us draw near to him. Every blessing to you.
I have come to give you life, that you might have it more abundantly. For I am the Lord Most High. I am your Savior God. I am the Lord that healeth thee. I am the one who sets you free. Whatever you need, I will do it for you. I am the mighty God. I have come to give you life, a life can stand before me. Sickness runs away. speak.